day and every hour. Oh, you are faithful, oh Lord. Every day, every day. Oh, and every hour. Oh, you are faithful, oh Lord. Oh, Mazuba, Mazuba, hallelujah.
This evening, for we know that Lord of Father, where two or three are gathered in your name, Lord, you are in their midst, oh God.
Amen.
We are gathered, Lord of Father, this evening, Lord of Father, to actually worship and pray, oh Father, Lord, as you know that, Lord, you have no other place to go, Father, but in thee, Lord of Father, we have our refuge, that you are our fortress, Lord of God. My dear Lord of Father, we thank you, Lord of Father, for you have enabled us, oh Father, to come and assemble, Lord of Father, in this manner, not by our mighty, not by our intelligence, oh God, but Father, Lord, by your will, oh Father, Lord, and your blessing upon our lives, oh God. Father, we pray that, Lord of Father, as we are here, oh Father, Lord, fellowship around the word of God, we know the word of Father is the one that brings unto us, Lord of Father, Lord, and consolation, oh Father, Lord, and hope, oh Father, Lord, in thee, oh God. And we commit this service into your hands, Lord of Father. May you anoint, oh Father, the singing of the songs, Lord of Father. May you anoint the preaching of the word, oh Father, Lord, that at the end of the day, oh God, oh Father, we can say, Lord of Father, like those from your mouth, Lord, in our hearts, been within us, Lord of Father, you have spoken to us, Lord. That it, dear Lord, each and every one of us, oh God, Father, can say, Lord of Father, you have spoken unto us, Lord of Father. We do commit this service into your hands. In the blessed name of our Lord Savior Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen. We are just going to be going to the Word at this time. We know that the Word has got comfort. No man can comfort another man, and the man can be comforted, but God can be comforting.
Hallelujah.
Comforting, we get it from the Word of the living God.
Amen.
So Pastor Freddy Chireka here tonight, that is going to break the bread of life for us. Today, praise the name of the Lord. Let's pray for him. in our hearts that God can speak to us, speak to the family during this time of bereavement. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Taura ishe taura ishe taura taura ishe taura ishe taura ishe taura o moyo wangu ishe taura o moyo wangu taura ishe taura ishe taura taura ishe taura ishe taura ishe taura o moyo wangu ishe taura a moyo wangu taura ishe taura ishe taura taura ishe taura ishe taura ishe taura o moyo wangu ishe taura o moyo wangu imba imba ishe imba 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 ishe imba ishe imba o moyo wangu ishe imba.
And the brethren that has come with, Father, we just want to commit this service into your hands. May you help us.
Yes, Lord.
Father, we know that our hearts are
let
in pain.
Be,
Lord, when we sit down and hear what happened, our hearts are broken eternal.
Hallelujah.
That's what sometimes comes in our path of duty. So we are just here to be of comfort to the family. Amen.
Amen.
So let me just quickly read a scripture so that those who are standing can be seated. Those of us who can stand, it's just good for us to just honor the word.
Amen.
Those of us who can't, we will also understand that.
Yes.
Amen. John chapter 14. I will just read verse 1 to verse 4. And that's where I'll base the little thoughts that I believe that will be a comfort to the family and to the believers. John chapter 14, verse 1. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God. You believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. Go and prepare a place for you. I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may also be. And whither I go, you know, and the way you know. May God bless the reading of his word.
Amen.
We may be seated. Just for a few minutes that we have, you know, we know that as African people, it's within us. When one of us is going through a difficult time, we always come together. And we come and, you know, we sing songs. You know, there's something about us as, you know, people of God. When we are happy, we sing songs. When we are sad, we also sing songs.
Amen.
So I felt really comforted as the pastor was leading us into some songs here. So I just want to talk for a few minutes on the blessed promise. So I just want to talk about the blessed promise. I trust that the few words from the word of God will be a comfort in this difficult time. So where we read here, John chapter 14, we hear the Lord saying that let not your hearts be troubled.
Amen.
You believe in God and believe also in me.
Mm.
I was talking to Sister Bridget, you know, getting to know that we come from the same area back home, And we know this scripture very well. There's a song that we actually sing, John 14, verse 1.
Amen.
Mm. It talks about, you know, comfort during these troubled times.
Amen.
Yeah. John 14, verse 1. Verse 1. John 14, verse 1.
Glory!
Moyo yewantini ngareke kumani kitswa tindai wopuna baba motenda nekwandiri veswa ariko ariko munyaradzi Jesu ariko ariko munyaradzi Jesu moyo yewantini ngareke kumani kitswa tindai wopuna baba motenda nekwandiri. That's a song that when we are back at home,
yeah,
when we go through times like this, this is a song that people can sing all night.
Amen.
And it brings some comfort, taken from this scripture here.
Amen.
So my few comments on this scripture, when the Lord was speaking like this, his life on earth was coming to an end. And he was giving an assurance to his disciples that, yes, my mortal life, my life here on earth, it's coming to an end, but death is not the end.
That's right.
You know, we would be very much of miserable people if our religion could just end at death.
Hey, sure.
You know, death is a full stop to many things.
Mm. Yes.
You know, you can go to school, you can be a successful businessman, you can do whatever you can do. But when this moment comes,
yes,
it stops everything.
Yeah, that's right.
And we start to realize that all the things that maybe we chase the rest of our lives, when we come to a moment like this, it's a full stop. But Jesus was coming with a new way of faith. He was telling his disciples that as my life is coming to an end here, death is not the end.
Yes.
You know, for a Christian, death is not the end.
That's right, man.
I know that death is painful. And if we look at the death that our Lord went through, it was one of the most cruel death.
Yes.
But he had a blessed hope. He had a blessed promise. Amen. He knew that his life was not going to you know, end with death. Amen. His life was simply going to start.
Amen.
See, death for a Christian is a promotion.
Amen.
Hallelujah. In this life, we go through troubles.
That's right.
In this life, there are, you know, disappointments.
Mm.
In this life, there are diseases. In this life, you know, things sometimes go wrong.
Mm.
But for a Christian, amen, our life is not just measured by the things that we go through in this mortal life.
Yes.
Our life is not ended in death. Death is a transport for a child of God to bring him in the presence of God.
All right.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
So he says here, let not your hearts be troubled. You know that my life is coming to an end. Amen.
Amen.
You know, I believe that it was Apostle Paul who wrote that, you know, when this earthly tabernacle dissolves, when this body, when it dissolves,
come on now.
Amen. Hallelujah. There is another one waiting.
Amen.
There is another one which will not have any sickness. There is another one without high blood pressure. There is another one without sugar diabetes. There is another one which will never test positive.
Hallelujah.
There's another one which will not get sick. There's another one which will not call for an ambulance.
All right.
It's a body that is made after the image of the Word.
Yes.
After theophany. Amen. So when we leave this body, we go into another one. Amen. It's a promotion. There will be no worries. There will be no troubles in that land. Hallelujah. So Jesus says, as my life is coming to an end here, amen, I am going for a purpose. My life here has been for a purpose. I came here to prepare the way for you. I came here to say that when death comes, it's not the end of a brother. It's not the end of a sister.
That's right.
Yeah. I am just coming to make a way so that I go and make a better place.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Glory.
You know, in this life, we grow up with, you know, ambitions. We have our own plans. Maybe let me use the example of the children of Israel.
Mm.
They were in bondage.
Yes.
They were being troubled by Pharaoh.
Mm.
And that's a typical life that we all live.
That's right.
Amen. Amen. Maybe when you have finished, you know, paying for the house, there is another trouble.
Yeah.
Mkulu, we are gula ekaya. You know, they steal your car, they do this. Amen. This life is just full of troubles.
Amen. Yes. Wow.
So when the children of Israel were there in that land of Egypt, they were being troubled. And God raised a prophet.
Oh,
yes. The prophet came and gave them, you know, hope. He came to tell them that there is a land that God has prepared for you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I am here to take you to that land. Maybe some of them had never heard of that land.
Amen.
They had never seen that land.
Absolutely.
But the prophet came and says, there is a land that God has prepared for you.
Amen.
Amen. And we know how God used a prophet. You know, every time when God wants to do something major, he uses a prophet.
All right.
For the first Exodus, there was a prophet that God used. Amen. And what was the purpose of the prophet? To bring them out from Egypt into the promised land.
Amen.
Amen. But that was just in a type and in a shadow. Because when they came there, amen, death was still an enemy.
All right. All right.
Yeah, God gave them plots. God gave them their inheritance. But after a while, there was a hill where they will have to bury, you know, their grandfather. There was a hill where they will bury a child.
Amen.
You know, sometimes, you know, when you get to understand what happens to other people, you start to realize that every day you ought to thank God if you are still alive.
Amen. All right.
That's you know, there's a brother who was visiting Jeffersonville just a few, you know, weeks ago, and he was sending some pictures. So he sent me another picture which touched me so much. He was talking about the son of the prophet, Billy Paul. And I didn't know that. You know, Billy Paul had about 4 children that he buried. And those 4 children, most of them just survived for either a day or so, and then they passed on. And it's 4 of those. And their deaths where they were, you know, they were born and buried, and he was actually taking pictures of that. I didn't know about that. Sometimes there are certain things that happen in our lives. We cannot explain them.
Amen.
We would not wish, you know, at one point, Brother Bram says, if I was deaf, I would not come to a home such as this one. I would not come and knock here to take a loved one from, you know, from the family. But sometimes God allows it for a purpose.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Sometimes it's difficult for us to understand. You know, Brother Branham went through an experience. He lost a daughter. How old was the daughter? I think 8 months or something.
8 months, yeah.
Amen. Mm. You know, that was, he lost his wife and he lost the daughter. It was such a, you know, painful experience.
Yeah.
And you know what? You cannot be able to console someone until you feel what they're feeling.
Amen.
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 You know, just a couple of a month ago, we went to Tsakani Extension 15. One of our sisters lost a mother. And this is what I said to them, that, you know what, I am not qualified to comfort you. Because I have not lost a mother. I don't know how it feels to lose a mother.
That's right.
But I can tell you, my wife over there, she lost her mother sometime last year in August. I said, sister, that's the person who can be able to comfort you because she has gone through the same experience.
Exactly.
You know, sometimes we can come and say, no, be strong, don't cry. No, 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 no. You don't know what a person is going through.
Absolutely right.
Amen. Because the pain is there.
All right.
And it takes time, you know, long after we've buried, you know, the mother. Sometimes at night she just can't sleep, you know. Sometimes at night she's just agonizing. Why? There is a pain that goes with that.
Absolutely.
And it's understandable.
Amen.
That's right.
But what I'm here to encourage you, my sister, what I'm here to encourage you as the family here, is that nothing happens without it being the will of God.
Amen.
You see, God's purpose for our lives. We know our birthdays. And when that time for birthdays come, we are quick to come to celebrate, and we should do that. We should celebrate that. But there is a date that God hides from us.
Mm.
the day where we are going to leave this earth here. He hides that one from us.
All right.
He won't tell us that because if he can tell you, brother, to say on such a day, if he can tell me, I want to go to work, brother, I'll be crying, I'll be doing like this.
That's right.
So those things, they do happen. But I want to tell you that God has to give a stamp of approval before someone can go.
Amen.
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 Without God giving that approval, you won't go. Even if they shoot you, you will survive.
Yeah.
Even if you are involved in a terrible accident, if it's not yet your time,
come on now.
That's right.
Amen. Amen. That's why Job understood that. You see, Job, he was going through a process. And, you know, the pain that he went through, I don't think that we can read about it, we can preach about it, but very few of us can really experience that. Because it was a painful experience.
Beautiful.
But I like this. There was a purpose for it.
Amen.
God was showing to Job that this life here, it's in the hands of God.
That's right.
Today you are here. You are like a flower. You bloom up. And after some time, you are gone.
Yeah.
And it should be something that should register. That all of us, as we are here, you must be ready.
Aye.
Because anytime, you know, in the few quotations that I was reading, he says that death is so uncertain.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't matter whether you are healthy or you are not healthy. It doesn't matter your age. It doesn't, one young boy went to his father sometime. And he said, Daddy, I want you to tell me something. At what age do people die? That was a question.
Mm-hmm.
When the father had that question, that was a striking question. He pretended to be busy. He went into the bedroom. Why? He was also thinking to say, how do I answer the other? Because it was a difficult question. Mm-hmm. At what age do people die? Then, when he was sleeping, he came up with an idea. He had a car. In the next morning, he said, young man, jump in the car. Let's go somewhere. The young man jumped in, and they drove to the cemetery. When they went to the cemetery, they now started explaining to the young boy. You see here, it's graves of old people. So old people die. Here it's graves of politicians. Politicians, they die.
Amen.
Here it's graves of doctors. Doctors, they die. Here it's graves of children. Some of them, they just lived for a day and they died. So there is no particular age.
Come on now.
It's a secret that God holds in us. But I'm here to comfort you. You see, when God sent Moses to take the children away from Egypt, to take them into the promised land, still there was a problem. There was still an enemy called death.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Amen. Yeah. So even when they get their inheritance, when they get their farms, when they get their plots and their farming the grapes and everything, after a while, they have to cry again because one in the family dies.
Yeah.
Amen. But when Jesus came, he was now bringing another dispensation to say, when I go, I am going to a place where I create a body for you. I'm preparing a place so that when you come here, we will live forever.
Amen.
And that's the promise that we have in this gospel.
Amen.
Our gospel is not just for us to have money. Our gospel is not for us to have good families. Our gospel is not just for us to go to church on a Sunday. Our gospel carries a promise of the resurrection.
Amen.
Those that die in Christ, they will rise again.
Amen.
There is another body.
Hallelujah.
That's why Job, when he was going through those problems, God came, you know, in that whirlwind. God came to show him that there is going to be a resurrection.
Hallelujah.
When God came, he showed him a vision. And Job rises up and says, I know my Redeemer liveth.
Amen.
Job was no longer looking at the troubles of his cows dying, of his sheep dying, of his children dying. No. Job was seeing the perfect picture.
Mm. Yes.
He was seeing now the death of Jesus Christ. Amen. And he was also seeing the resurrection of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And he didn't just see the resurrection of Jesus Christ. He also saw his own resurrection.
Amen.
And when he began to speak, he says, even if my skin worms eat of my body.
Yes.
Amen. Let me tell you, children of God, you have got some worms that you have.
Amen.
If you go to the doctor, they will tell you, you have some worms that you have. The worms that are going to eat you, they are already in you.
Mm.
Amen. They are waiting to be called to duty. Amen. Sometimes when we misbehave, they start eating us alive. Ask this man called Herod. You know, he was speaking, and then people said he speaks like a god. He was so proud. And when he did that, the worms started eating him alive. Amen. So the worms that are going to eat you, they're already in you.
Yes.
But they cannot start their job until God gives the go-ahead.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. That's why when the prophet of God, you know, brings this thing, he says, our bodies are just worth 84 cents. Our bodies, we love them so much. We take care of them. Some of us spend hours looking at that body and just making sure that we present it well. But it's the most useless thing. It's the most useless thing.
Amen.
I can tell you that even when a chicken dies, it's worth more than a human being. Because with a chicken, we can put it in the kitchen. But us, we are worth 84 cents. We are worth nothing.
Preacher.
Amen.
But there is something that is in us that God has put in us, which is called a soul.
Amen.
That's the most important thing.
Amen.
And when the preacher preaches it, he says it's worth 10,000 worlds.
Well,
amen. And you know what? With that soul that we have, many of us don't take care of the soul. Many of us don't bring that soul to be in contact with God.
Yes.
Huh? If you don't want to, connect yourself with God, then don't die. Because if you die, you are going to wake up in another place. Amen. But those that have made peace with their maker, they know that any moment, in less than 5 minutes, in less than 10 seconds,
yes,
when death strikes, you are in another boat.
All right.
Because that body is already waiting. It's there. It's close to you. You just jump from this mortal body into an immortal body.
Amen.
Amen. So God has given us a promise of the resurrection.
That's right.
Amen. Death is not the end.
Yes.
Our loved ones, we shall see them again.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We shall see them. They can come to us, but we have to go to them.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. But for us to go to them, we must make sure that we must believe like they believed. Amen. We must be connected to God like they are connected.
Amen.
The only way we can meet again is when we are all Christians. Amen. So, what's the purpose? Why are we gathered here? We are here to comfort one another.
Amen.
Amen. We are here to remind one another.
Amen.
You know, when we gather like this, we don't know when is the next, session like this. Amen.
Amen.
It might be that you'll be gathering for me.
Mm-hmm.
It might be that we are gathering for you.
Yes.
You see how it is? It's so serious that we must be ready all the time.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Absolutely.
We must be ready. And sometimes God comes and take a loved one from us.
Yeah.
Just to make sure that others, they know that they've got to prepare.
Mm-hmm. That is true.
Amen. God comes and takes a loved one to get your attention. Because this service here was never going to be a service like this without what happened.
Yeah. That's right.
So everything has got a purpose.
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
Mm.
But I want to assure you, the best policy you can take. Amen.
Come on now.
There are policies that we take and we should take to take care of ourselves. You know, if you know that at some point you can get sick, what do? You prepare for that time. Life is all about preparations. When our children are growing, we are sending them to school. What are we doing? We are preparing them for tomorrow.
Amen.
If you don't prepare, trouble is waiting for you. So if we don't send our children to school, what is it? They're going to be a trouble tomorrow. So everything is about preparation. We prepare for this body. We prepare for our children. We prepare for everything. But we should never forget one policy, which is called the Blessed Assurance Policy.
All right. Come on now.
Amen.
We can take care of this one, how it will go down. But what about the soul? That soul must be in contact with God.
Yes.
Don't live a risky life where if something happens, a car hits you, you wake up in hell. Don't live such a life. Amen. We are here, family. We are here to reach out to members of the family to say, you know what? When things are happening like this, God is giving us a warning.
Amen.
When you see the ambulance going up and down, it's just showing you that one day it might be you in that ambulance.
Mm.
When you pass by and there is an accident, just know that one day it could be you there.
Mm.
Amen. And God is preparing us for that.
That's right. Hallelujah.
Amen. The greatest thing that one can ever be is to be a Christian that is connected with
yes,
God.
Sir.
Death will not scare you.
Amen.
Death
Amen.
Becomes a transport Amen. To take you into the presence
Amen.
Of God. Death becomes like, you know, a man who has gone to work with an overall. You know, the overall gets dirty. And when you want to go home, what do? You take it off.
All right.
And you are smart.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Hallelujah. This old body, there is a time that we are going to shake
All
it.
All right.
Amen.
Because this life is like living in an overall.
Oh.
We desire a better body.
All right.
We desire eternal youth.
Right.
We desire to be young. We desire to be happy. Never to be hungry.
Yes,
where
sir.
We go to a place where God will wipe all the tears of our
eyes.
Where there will be no sleepless night, man.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Where there will be no worry. Where there will be no pain. God is preparing us for that place.
Hallelujah.
The Lord has gone. It's been long. I mean, we see the events. We see what's happening all over. We know it's about time.
Absolutely.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, we want to pray before I hand over back to the pastor.
Amen.
We're just here. It's not an all night. We're just here just to leave a few words of comfort.
Amen.
So, shall we just bow our heads?
Amen.
Want to pray.
Amen.
There's something that the preaching of the word of God does.
Mm.
Even when our hearts are crushed, even when we have no answer to the things that we see happening around us, we can still be like Job.
Hallelujah.
Who can say, the Lord has given, the Lord has taken, painful as it is.
Yes.
You know, Job came to a point where he even said, even though he slay me, even though he sent me to hell, even if things happen and I don't understand them, yet I will still praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yet I will still honor him and obey him. Want to pray? If there is anybody who wants to be remembered in prayer, you know, sometimes our hearts are so broken, we don't even know where to start. But we thank God that there is a promise of resurrection that he has given us. Death is not the end. Death is not a full stop. Death to a Christian is just a continuation of the same life in another realm. If you want to be remembered in prayer, maybe God is speaking to your heart. If you want to say, God, remember me, help me, I'm not ready. Should the Lord call me? You know, when we were hearing, you know, what happened, it was just a short illness. And anything like that can happen to any one of us.
That's true.
For us to be here today is just the grace of God.
Mm.
It's not because we are clever. It's not because we can do things better. No, it's just the grace of God.
Yes.
If there is anyone who wants to be remembered in prayer, we are happy to do that. Shall we pray? Mighty Heavenly Father, we pray that the spirit of comfort come down in this place.
Amen.
Lord, when we hear what has happened here, our hearts are broken.
Yes.
Our hearts are in pain. Yet, Lord, we are able to raise our hands and say, you are still God. We don't question why this happens. We don't seek to understand. Though we are in pain, we know that when something happens, you, for a great purpose, you would have allowed it to happen. Lord, we know that there is a mystery that you are holding in each and every one of our lives. We don't know when you're going to call us. We don't know when the next card is being called up yonder. But Father, we want to be ready. We've been sharing your word here, and there might be someone who say, God is speaking to my heart.
Amen.
There might be someone who wants to say, at that funeral service, at that comfort service, I decided to think on my ways and accept the Lord Jesus Christ and start a journey with him. Father, I pray you that can search the intents of the heart, you that can see what is in the inside of the inside, may you bless those that are making the right decision.
Yes.
May you undertake for them. Mm. May this be a time. Those who are far from you, Lord, may you bring them closer.
Yes.
Those that have forgotten you, Lord, may you draw them into a revival. Mighty God, we pray, committing everything to you, saying, Lord, may after all these things that we've done, the comfort, the song, the singing, and the preaching, Lord, may you be the one that will be the after speaker that will come and comfort. Lord, this is a huge burden. May you come and lift it. You promised that you would send us the comforter. May the Holy Ghost come and comfort the family here, comfort the believers, comfort all of us in the name of Jesus Christ. We commit ourselves to you, Lord, in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Amen and amen.
Amen.
God bless you. It's a handover to you.
Amen. Wonderful.
Amen.
I mean, the word wasn't it good?
Amen.
The word is always comforting our hearts.
Amen.
To know that everything happens for a reason and for a purpose. And we are here to accomplish that purpose in our lives. Praise the name of the Lord. I want us to maybe stand all of us on our feet and maybe sing one song. And then maybe just a worshiping song, just to water the seed that has went down today. And we believe that God will do something for us.
Glory. You are Alpha. Oh, Omega, we worship you, our Lord. You are worthy to be praised. Oh, you are Alpha, Lord. You are Alpha.
Closing it.